Tonight, 60 stars of stage and screen have gathered to celebrate 60 years of honoring excellence in theater.
And the winner is...
And the winner is...
And the winner is...
And the Tony Award is awarded to...
Come get it, Hal.
I'm gonna break my nails.
May I say, Dankeschön, merci, thank you, thank you, thank you.
Because I've been wanting to give it to directors for years.
And all of you, thank you. It's a great honor.
I'm very, very grateful and proud.
I always wanted one of these, and I'm glad I got it.
Thank you so much.
To win, I only had a losing speech prepared.
With performances from the nominated musicals of this season. Live from Radio City Music Hall, it's the American Theater Wing's 60th Annual Tony Awards. Presented by the League of American Theaters and Producers and the American Theater Wing. And now, please welcome Tony nominee, Harry Connick Jr.
Good evening. How y'all feeling tonight? Tonight won't be just any night. Tonight there will be no morning star. Tonight I'll see my love tonight. And for us, stars won't stop where they are. Now this next one's a little bit of a New Orleans style. I hope you like it. Oh, that's old school right there.
Give my regards to Broadway. Remember me to Herald Square. Tell all the gang at 42nd Street that I will soon be there. Whisper of how I'm yearning to mingle with the old-time throng. Give my regards to old Broadway and say that I'll be there ere long.
And Irving Berlin, of course.
There's no business like show business, like no business I know. Everything about it is appealing, everything the traffic will allow. Nowhere could you get that happy feeling when you're stealing that extra bow.
Joining me are 60 stars to help welcome you to the 60th Annual Tony Awards.
There's no people like show people. They never ever run out of dough. Yesterday they told you you would not go far. That night you opened and there you are. Next day on your dressing room they hung a star. Let's go on with the show. Let's go. On with the show.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
Please welcome the first two of our 60 stars, Kira Sedgwick and Josh Lucas.
The first award of the 60th Annual Tonys is for the best performance by a featured actor in a play. Previous Tony winners in this category range from hilarious comic turns by Alan Arkin, Walter Matthau and Matthew Broderick, and to serious dramatic roles by Lawrence Fishburne, Eli Wallach, and Al Pacino.
This year's five nominated actors have distinguished themselves with outstanding performances that are at times comic, sympathetic, powerful, and always thoughtful and engrossing. The nominees for Best Performance by a Featured Actor in a Play are Samuel Barnett in The History Boys. Donnell Gleeson in The Lieutenant of Inishmore. Ian McDermott in Faith Healer. Mark Ruffalo in Awake and Sing. And Pablo Schreiber in Awake and Sing.
And the 2006 Tony Award goes to Ian McDermott, Faith Healer.
In his Broadway debut, veteran actor Ian McDermott wins the Tony for his brilliant portrayal of Teddy in the revival of Faith Healer.
Ladies and gentlemen, I got off a plane from London just under 2 short months ago, and I'm astonished to be standing before so many of you here tonight. It gives me a chance to pay tribute to my distinguished acting colleagues, Ralph Fiennes, Cherry Jones, great artists both, and my very good friend, the director, Jonathan Kent, who he enabled us to give life to one of the most emotionally intricate and musically perfect pieces of writing for the stage in the English language, written unsurprisingly by an Irishman, Brian Friel. Brian Friel's Faith Healer had its debut on Broadway over 20 years ago and was not a success. I'm really proud to be associated with its triumphant return and restoration. These are two words that occur in the play regularly, and there's one other word that my character uses that perhaps I should mention. He's a London show business manager and therefore totally unreliable and prone to wild exaggeration, but it fits the occasion, and it's the way I feel tonight. Fantastic! Thank you.
Please welcome Academy Award-winning actress Anna Paquin, along with two-time Tony winner Frank Langella.
Good evening. We're here to present the award for Best Performance by a Featured Actress in a Play. Some of the actresses who've won this award in the past are Anne Bancroft, Christine Baranski, Swoosie Kurtz, and Maureen Stapleton.
Among the nominees tonight are experienced stage veterans, a past Tony winner, and actresses who are making their Broadway debuts. The nominees for Best Performance by a Featured Actress in a Play are Tyne Daly in Rabbit Hole, Frances de la Tour in The History Boys, Jane Houdyshell in Well, Alison Pill in The Lieutenant of Inishmore, and Zoe Wanamaker in Awake and Sing.
And the Tony Award goes to Frances de la Tour.
After a 35-year absence from the Broadway stage, Frances de la Tour returns with a true tour de force, taking home her first Tony Award, portraying Miss Lintott in the play The History Boys.
I'm totally amazed to be given this special honor by the Tony voters. I want to thank a lot of people really, but just a very few tonight. The most important people I really want to thank first off is the backstage people. They are totally amazing. Our stage management, our wardrobe, our stage crew, their enthusiasm and their affection for us is making our stay here so memorable. We really do feel part of New York, New York. I also want to thank my dear friends Nick Heitner Alan Bennett, Bob Crowley, and the wonderful cast of History Boys and Men, and to Bob Boyette and all our producers and the Schubert Organization. Thank you so very much for having us. I'm very thrilled to be here. Thank you.
Still more stars to come, including Julia Roberts, Oprah Winfrey, Glenn Close, Joe Pesci, Julie Andrews, and Bernadette Peters. And up next, presentations by Cheetah Rivera and Bebe Neuwirth, Mark Ruffalo and Juliana Margulies, and a performance from The Drowsy Chaperone when we return on CBS. The 60th Annual Tony Awards, sponsored by... Once you've built Jets, you don't build just another car. Saab, born from Jets. And yes, there's an insurance company that's as responsible as you are. Liberty Mutual.
Performing 8 times a week in the Broadway show Grand Hotel, directed by Tommy Toon, opposite Michael Jeter, was one of the best and most creative experiences I ever had. None of us were prepared for the speech that he gave that evening.
If you're out there somewhere tonight and you've got a problem with alcohol or drugs and you can't stop, you think life can't change and that dreams can't come true, then I stand here as living proof that you can stop.
And that night, his words touched the heart and soul of everybody watching.
It changes a day at a time and dreams come true.
Please welcome two-time Tony winners, Bebe Neuwirth and Cheetah Rivera.
Hi, Bebe. Jane Krakowski shared her favorite Tony memory when more than 110 Tony winners gathered for a once-in-a-lifetime photograph.
Performers came from as far away as Europe to take part in this incredible event. Now, to celebrate 60 years of the Tonys, here's that historic photograph.
Ooh, I see me.
I don't see me.
You'll hear more Tony memories throughout the night. And now, the award for best choreography.
Bob Fosse said, "Dance expresses joy better than anything else," and I don't think we would think anything else but that.
Each of the four talented artists nominated tonight advanced the art, communicating emotions not just through movement, but their originality, technique, and dedication to perfection. The nominees are Rob Ashford, the wedding singer, Donald Byrd, The Color Purple, Kathleen Marshall, The Pajama Game, and Casey Nicholaw, The Drowsy Chaperone.
And the American Theatre Wing's Tony Award goes to Kathleen Marshall, The Pajama Game.
Having won in 2004 for her choreography of Wonderful Town, this marks Kathleen Marshall's second Tony win. She's also nominated tonight for Best Direction of a Musical.
Oh my God, The Pajama Game is a joyous show. It was a joy to do from beginning to end, and now I get to share this joy with a bunch of brilliant and wonderful people, starting with our cast, Kelly O'Hara, Michael McKean, Megan Lawrence, Joyce, Peter Ross, the brilliant Harry Connick. Thank you for coming to Broadway, Harry. Our brilliant design team, Derek McLean, Marty Pakladinas, Peter Kazarowski, Brian Ronan, and Paul Huntley. Our brilliant music team, Rob Berman, Danny Troub, Dick Lieb, the great David Chase, all of our authors, especially Richard Adler and Peter Ackerman. All of our producers, Todd Haynes and The Roundabout, Jeffrey Richards, Jim Fuld, and Scott Landis. My great assistants, Vince Pesch and Mark Bruni, Jim Carnahan, George Lane. And I especially get to stand here and tell my family and my friends how much I love them and appreciate their support, my parents, my brother, my sister, and my pal Rob Ashford. 20 years ago, we moved together to New York and we're roommates, two chorus kids, just, you know, hoping to work in the theater. And now look at us. This is wild. Thank you so, so very much.
Please welcome two stars seen on Broadway this year, Juliana Margulies, and a nominee tonight for Awake and Sing, Mark Ruffalo.
Tyrone Guthrie, who won the Tony in 1956 for Best Direction of The Matchmaker, said that directing is filling everyone with the desire to come back to work at 10 o'clock the next morning.
It's also been said that a director's most important job is creating an atmosphere in which others can create. The nominees for Best Director of a Play have proven their mastery of this skill through their unique insight, ingenuity, and vision.
And the nominees are Nicholas Heitner, The History Boys. Wilson Milam, The Lieutenant of Inishmore. Bartlett Sher, Awake and Sing. And Daniel Sullivan, Rabbit Hole.
And the Tony goes to Nicholas Heitner, The History Boys.
With Tony nominations for both producing and directing, Nicholas Heitner takes home his second Tony Award for Best Direction tonight.
I want to first thank my colleagues at the National Theatre, where collectively we produced The History Boys a couple of years ago. They brought to it the same imagination and energy that they bring to the 20-odd shows we do each year. I want to thank Bob Boyette and Bill Haber, our passionate and imaginative producers here on Broadway, and for their generosity as well as for much else. I want to thank my stupendous National Theatre acting company, who are even more fun offstage than they are on. And above all, I thank Alan Bennett. Over the past few years, we've done four plays and two movies together, and he is the best luck I've ever had. Thank you very much.
He said thank you. Suppose I should have chosen a less popular phrase. It's a little drinking game. Anyway, hello. How are we this evening? Good, I'm feeling a little blue myself. Whenever I'm feeling this way, blue, I like to listen to my music. So I was going through my records this morning, and what did I find but my favorite show, The Drowsy Chaperone. Oh, good, you know it. 1928, let me read you what it says in the back. Mix-ups, mayhem, and a gay wedding. Well, of course, the phrase gay wedding has a different meaning now, but back then it just meant fun. And that's all this show is, fun. Oh, I love playing my records. It's as if the musicals come to life in my apartment. Oh, this is one of my favorite songs. It's called Show Off. In it, the bride, the glamorous Janet Vandegraaff, entertains questions from reporters as she lounges by the pool.
Miss Vandegraaff, is it true you're giving up a successful career to marry a man on the stage?
Yes.
So you won't be returning to the stage, ever?
I shan't.
You shan't?
I shan't.
I have a question. How can you give up the footlights when you know very well you got grease paint in your veins?
Oh, Victor, if you think this is about vanity, you couldn't be more wrong. I don't want to show off no more. I don't want to sing tunes no more. I don't want to ride moons no more. I don't want to show off. I don't want to wear this no more. I play the saucy Swiss Miss no more. I blow my signature no more. I don't want to show off.
Janet, please.
Don't try to control me. I've made up my mind. And that's it. I quit. I'm leaving it all behind. I don't want to be cute no more. Make the gentleman hoot no more. I don't want to wear fruit no more. I don't want to show off.
She don't want to show off.
show off.
She don't want to show off no more. Off no more.
Not me. Woo!
James Earl Jones and Cynthia Nixon. Up next, presentations by Paul Rudd, Lauren Ambrose, Barbara Cook, Paul Schaefer, Neil Patrick Harris, and Joanna Gleason. And a performance from Sweeney Todd as the 60th Annual Tony Awards returns on CBS. Welcome two stars of stage and screen currently appearing on Broadway, from Awake and Sing, Lauren Ambrose, and from 3 Days of Rain, Paul Rudd.
Tim Rice, the Tony-winning lyricist of Aida and winning lyricist and writer of Evita, says, when writing a musical, the first thing to do is to get the book right.
From two faithful adaptations of popular films to the recounting, oh, I need LASIK, to the recounting of a rags to riches, help me out here, life history, to a riotous musical that comes to life in a studio apartment, is that right? Yeah, awesome. The book writers have conquered the challenge, I really do need that surgery, of telling the challenge of, a strong story,
yeah. The nominees for Best Book of a Musical are Marcia Norman for the book of The Color Purple, Bob Martin and Don McKellar for the book of The Drowsy Chaperone, Marshall Brickman and Rick Ellis for the book of Jersey Boys, Chad Beglin and Tim Herlihy for the book of The Wedding Singer.
And the 2006 Tony Award goes to The Drowsy Chaperone, Bob Martin and Don McKellar.
Writer Don McKellar takes home his first ever Tony for The Drowsy Chaperone. Also winning this award is actor and writer Bob Martin, who is nominated tonight for a leading actor in a musical.
Thank you, America. This is so wonderful. This show expresses the voice of a group of writers and performers in Toronto, and we want to share this award with them. Not literally, but figuratively. And also on behalf of my agents, I just want to thank Janet Vandegraaff for marrying me in the first place.
We share this award with our inspirational leader and director and friend, Casey Nicholaw. And without him, we would have been deported back to Canada a long time ago. And I wish we had time to thank other people, but we really don't. If we did, I would thank Kevin and Royal, our producers, the Lisa, Matt, Greg, Matt, Walsh, Matt yes. And my parents, my girlfriend Tracy. But we don't have time for that list. So instead, let me just thank the American musical comedy that's been around for about 100 years now, inspiring people, transporting them, and giving people like Bob and me lots of material to make fun of. So we're so honored to be in this company. Thank you.
Please welcome a Tony winner for The Music Man and a music man who's made his Broadway debut in the orchestra of The Magic Show, Barbara Cook and Paul Schaefer.
We've seen firsthand the wondrous, life-changing moment that takes place when a lyricist or composer hears their words or music performed for the first time by Broadway singers and musicians.
Perhaps the only more exciting sound is hearing that you've just won the Tony and that your name will go down in the history books.
The nominees for the Best Original Score, Music and or Lyrics Written for the Theater are The Color Purple, Music and Lyrics by Brenda Russell. Allie Willis and Stephen Bray. The Drowsy Chaperone, Music. Music and lyrics by Lisa Lambert and Greg Morrison. The Wedding Singer, music by Matthew Sklar, lyrics by Chad Beglin. And The Woman in White, music by Andrew Lloyd Webber, lyrics by David Zippel.
Barbara, oh my God, Cook. I can't believe it.
Oh, sweetie.
I can't believe it. It's really her. Thanks. And the Tony Award goes to The Drowsy Chaperone. Music and lyrics, Lisa Lambert and Greg Morrison.
With their first foray onto Broadway as both lyricists and composers, Lisa Lambert and Greg Morrison each earned their first Tony ever.
I'd like to thank my mom, and I'd like to thank my mom's friend, Nancy Marenstein, for reminding me to thank my mom. Casey Nicholaw, you joined our group of weird people a year ago, me and Greg and Don and Bob, and you brought this thing to life. Thank you to you and Casey Hushin and Josh Rhodes, our cast, our band, our fantastic musical wizards of Glenn Kelly and Larry Blank and Phil Reno and our wonderful producers. And also for anybody in Toronto who may have lived in Toronto between the years 1985 and 1995 and who received a singing telegram set to the tune of Take Me Out to the Ball Game, you can now say it was written by a Tony Award-winning songwriter. Greg.
A very quick thank you to my parents watching this in Kelly's Cross, Prince Edward Island. I'd just like to say thanks for buying that piano 30 years ago for $100 and putting it in the basement, tearing the stairs out. It started all this for me. Thank you. It's very honored to be here. Thank you very much.
Please welcome a Tony winner for Into the Woods and a Broadway star most recently seen in Assassins, Joanna Gleason and Neil Patrick Harris.
Our first nominee for Best Revival of a Musical is the chilling new interpretation of the 1979 Tony-winning Sweeney Todd. Stephen Sondheim and Hugh Wheeler's account of the razor-wielding half-mad bar... Half?
Three-quarters.
Mad barber who takes vengeance on the judge who unfairly punished him. Soon he turns his rage to others with the help of Mrs. Lovett, a peddler of unsavory meat pies.
Stripped down to an orchestral troupe of actor-musicians, the diabolical intricacies of Sondheim's lyrics come to the forefront of this widely acclaimed piece. Please welcome the brilliant cast, including Tony nominees Patti LuPone, Michael Cerveris, and Manuel Felciano, as we attend the tale of Sweeney Todd.
Sweeney Todd. His skin was pale and his eye was odd. He shaved the faces of gentlemen who never thereafter were heard of again. He trod a path that few have trod, did Sweeney Todd, the demon barber of Fleet Street.
Oh, wait, what you rush, what you hurry? You gave me such a fright, I thought you was a ghost. Half a minute, can't you sit? Sit you down, sit. All I meant is that I haven't seen a customer for weeks. Did you come here for a pie, sir? Do forgive me if me head's a little vague. Ooh, what is that? But you think we had the plague? From the way that people keep avoiding, no you don't. Heaven knows I try, sir. But there's no one comes in even to inhale. Right you are, sir, would you like a drop of ale? Mind you, I can hardly blame. These are probably the worst pies in London. I know, nobody cares to take them. I should know, I make them. But good now, the worst pies in London. Even that's polite, the worst pies in London. If you doubt it, take a bite.
These are my friends. See how they glisten. See this one shine. How he smiles in the light. My friend, my faithful friend. Rest now, my friends.
Never you fear,
soon I'll unfold you.
You can learn and soon.
Feel the splendors you never have dreamed of your day. My lucky friends, on your side, was merely silver.
Silver's good enough for me.
Friends, you shall drip rubies. You'll soon drip precious rubies.
At last my right arm is complete again! Attend the tale of Sweeney Todd. He served a dark and a vengeful god.
He served a dark and a vengeful god.
To seek revenge may lead to hell, but everyone does it and seldom as well. A Sweeney. A Sweeney Todd.
The demon barber of Fleet Street.
Academy Award winners Joe Pesci and Julia Roberts, plus Hank Azaria and Oliver Platt, and the Jersey Boys rock Radio City when we return on CBS. The 60th Annual Tony Awards, sponsored by Charles Schwab, proud sponsor of Live Broadway. Why should market performance dictate your performance? Talk to Chuck.
The Tony Award show is fun.
And the winner is Liza Minnelli, Indiana.
This award means more to me than any of the others, because this is where I started, this is what I wanted to do, and all these people are who I wanted to be with.
Please welcome an Academy Award-nominated actress and an Emmy-winning actor, Rosie Perez and Richard Thomas.
The season's plays show a diverse blend of new material. They were culturally driven monologues, size-splitting comedies, and thought-provoking dramas with deep political foundations.
Now, later on, you'll get a taste of the nominees for Best Play, but there were a number of other works that rounded out the season. Now, let's take a look back at the year in plays.
You on that show.
That's mortifying.
When I don't have anything in the afternoon.
You know, underneath that army uniform, you're still a young, vital woman.
Does the court wish to caution the witness about the gravity of the insinuated charge?
I'm not insinuating a thing, sir.
You know what, Michael? I don't mind what you do, but I do mind what you don't do.
What is it? The cooking? The cleaning? The crime?
I'll tell you exactly what it is. It's the cooking, the cleaning, and crying.
As I used to say, I didn't know beans about edamame.
Funny.
How come you ain't answering me, huh? Are you deaf?
Well, I may say I did acquit myself with honor. Oh, as did you, of course.
Tony nominee for Spam-A-Lot, along with a nominee tonight from Shining City, Hank Azaria and Oliver Platt.
In 1960, the Tonys added a new category, Best Direction of a Musical. Prior to that, only one Direction Award was given, either for work on a play or musical.
Since then, 48 awards have gone to directors of musicals, 8 of them to Hal Prince. Other honorees include, I know, only 8. Michael Bennett, Tommy Tune, Susan Stroman, and last year's winner for Spamalot, my friend Mike Nichols. This year's talented nominees for Best Direction. Mike is also friends with Oliver. Although I've been invited to the house in Martha's Vineyard. This year's talented nominees for Best Direction of a Musical are John Doyle for Sweeney Todd, Kathleen Marshall for The Pajama Game, Des McAnuff for Jersey Boys, and Casey Nicola for The Drowsy Chaperone.
The American Theater Wing's Tony Award goes to John Doyle, Sweeney Todd.
This marks John Doyle's first Tony Award nomination and win. In addition to directing the current revival of Sweeney Todd, he has also designed the costumes and sets.
First of all, I'd like to thank the rest of the creative team, Sarah, Richard, and Dan. And also, I would thank the costume designer and the set designer, but they've both given up the business after working with me, so it's not going to happen that way. Thank you to our wonderful producers, particularly my friend Richard Frankel, who's a very special person in my heart. Thank you to a wonderful, wonderful cast and crew who have made this show so, I hope, memorable to the Broadway audience. Thank you to my agent and friend Claire and to my partner Robert, who helps me through everything. Happy anniversary, Rob. And also, thank you to somebody who I hope we all hold in a very, very, very special place on Broadway, and that's, of course, the wonderful Stephen Sondheim. And finally, I'd like to dedicate this to all the directors and actors and designers and artists out there who knock on doors that don't get answers and who look for a break that they think is never going to come. And I hope they will remember this moment as living proof of the fact that it's never too late. Thank you very much.
Please welcome Academy Award winner, Joe Pesci.
Okay. No, this is not my security. These are the original Four Seasons. So, how did four regular guys become one of the greatest successes in pop music history? As the character Tommy DeVito says, ask four guys, you get four different answers. Ask me, you'll get the fifth. Why? Because I was there at the creation of the Four Seasons. Without me, it all began in New Jersey, back in the old neighborhood, under a street light with just a couple of guys singing harmony. But through all the success, these guys always remembered the old neighborhood. So let's go back home with our second nominee for Best Musical, Jersey Boys.
You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. You'd be like heaven to touch. So much at long last love has arrived, and I thank God I'm alive. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. Pardon the way that I stare. There's nothing else to compare. The sight of you leaves me weak. Just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. Just too good to be true.
They ask you, what was the high point? The Hall of Fame, selling all those records, pulling Sherry out of the hat. It was all great. But the first time the four of us made that sound, our sound, when everything dropped away and all there was the music. That was the best. That's why I'm still out there singing. Like that bunny on TV with the battery, I just keep going and going and going. Chasing the music. Trying to get home.
Who loves you, pretty baby? Who loves you, who loves you, pretty mama? Who's always there to make you cry? Who loves you, pretty baby? Who's gonna help you through the night? Who loves you, pretty mama? Who's always there to make you cry? Who loves you?
Who loves you, pretty baby? Who's gonna
next, Harvey Fierstein and Audra McDonald with 60 years of unforgettable Tony moments. Plus, Kristen Bell and Hal Holbrook, and a performance from The Wedding Singer. And still to come, Broadway legend Julie Andrews, when the 60th Annual Tony Awards returns on CBS. Together, they have 8 Tony Awards. Please welcome Audra McDonald and Harvey Fierstein.
A gay man's work is never done.
Thank you, honey. At the very first Tony Awards, the recipients were not given the familiar statue with the masks of comedy and tragedy. During the early days, the honorees were handed a medallion. The statue made its debut in 1967. As the American Theater Wing's Tonys evolved, so did their legacy.
The initial ceremonies were lavish dinners, recordings of which, like the shows they were celebrating, only exist in photographs, written accounts, and memories. Though a few of the events have been lost to the ages, let's look back at some unforgettable moments in 60 glorious years of the Tony Awards.
Join us, come and waste an hour or two.
It is a particular joy to be part of the theater's once a year night of nights, the annual Tony Awards celebration.
Hi, my name is Steve, and I'll be your waiter. The winner is the Elephant Man.
9.
Evita.
Daisy Eager.
Thank you, my wonderful agent, Francis Del Duca.
And the winner is the Phantom of the Opera.
Les Miserables.
Sweet that was.
The winner is Cats.
Turn your face to the moonlight. Let your memory lead you.
The stage is my home. This is the place that I love more than any place in the world.
Star of stage and screen, Emmy winner Tom Skerritt.
Thank you, thank you. Each year a Tony Award is presented to an outstanding regional theater that has displayed a continuous level of artistic achievement. Earlier this evening, Suzanne Lyons from Visa et Moi presented the Regional Theater Tony Award to an organization I am very, very happy to be involved with, Seattle's Intiman Theater.
This year, the Regional Theater Tony Award is accompanied by a grant for $25,000 from Visa.
We come to you from the far northwest corner of the world. I'm standing here with Laura Penn, who's my artistic partner and Intiman's managing director. Intiman is a company which really likes to push its work to the edge and has an old-fashioned belief that the work that we do as artists is deeply connected to our communities, an audience who have a great sense of adventure on the long, strange trip that we're trying to take at Intiman. Thanks very much.
Please welcome an actress who made her Broadway debut in The Adventures of Tom Sawyer, Kristen Bell, and the Tony winner for Mark Twain Tonight, Hal Holbrook.
I got a letter in my dressing room backstage in Spokane a week ago from a man who drove his family up to Elmira, New York to visit Mark Twain's grave. A man on the street gave him directions to the cemetery, and then he said, "By the way, you know that Hollywood actor, Hal Holbrook, who portrayed him? I believe he's buried close by." Identification with the role you're playing is all very well, but that's carrying it too far. But I can at last say the report of my death has been grossly exaggerated.
But it's no exaggeration to say the nominees of Best Revival of a Play are thoroughly engaging. They include Clifford Odette's Story of Belief in the American Dream, Somerset Maugham's Comedy of Marital Complications, Edward Albee's exploration of life, death, and evolving consciousness, and Brian Friel's Legend of a Traveling Healer.
And the nominees are Awake and Sing.
Without the dollar, you don't look the world in the eye. Talk from now to next year.
The Constant Wife.
Men were meant by nature to be wicked and delightful and to deceive their wives.
Edward Albee's Seascape.
We didn't feel we belonged anymore.
That's why you came up.
Faith Healer.
They knew in their hearts they had come not to be cured, but for confirmation that they were incurable.
And the Tony goes to Awake and Sing.
Accepting the award for Awake and Sing, producers Andre Bishop and Bernard Gersten.
Thank you. We are very grateful and we are deeply honored. But you don't get to win a Best Revival for a Tony unless you have the best possible production, which luckily we have. Superbly gifted actors in every role, wonderful designers, and a brilliant director. We thank them, and we thank the staff and board of Lincoln Center Theater. But Bernie and I would not be standing up here at all if we didn't have a play not only worth reviving, but in need of reviving. Awake and Sing by the great, great Clifford Odets.
Way back in ancient history, in 1935, when Awake and Sing had its original production by the famous Group Theater, the Tonys hadn't even been invented yet. So this is Awake and Sing's first Tony, and a well-deserved one it is, for this ultimate, extraordinary American play by a writer, by Clifford Odets, who with this award for the revival of his play takes his rightful place in the pantheon of great American playwrights and glorifies the extraordinary company that has brought his play back to miraculous life. Thank you very much.
Please welcome two stars who have appeared on the Broadway stage, Jamie Lynn Sigler and Molly Ringwald.
There are three things that every audience wants to do. They want to watch two characters they care about fall in love. They want to laugh.
And they want to see someone get whacked. The laughing and falling love part happens nightly at our third best musical nominee, The Wedding Singer. And so direct from Richfield, New Jersey, or as I call it, Exit 18.
Here is Tony nominee Stephen Lynch with the cast of The Wedding Singer.
We'll be right back.
wrote a song 6 years ago while playing in a wedding band. The word got out and suddenly the band and I are in demand. And now couples all over Jersey hire me to ensure their wedding kiss, all because of a tune I wrote. That tune goes like this. Oh, when it's your wedding day and my music starts to play, I can guarantee that love will find you. Yeah, when it's your wedding day, all the problems melt away if you count on me, 'cause love is what I do. Now when we play tune machine, Sammy does Van Halen licks while George gets down on tambourine. We might play you some Careless Whisper or make you wish you had Jesse's girl instead. Bring the ring out with endless love and blast, bang your head,
bang your head.
So when it's your wedding day and my music starts to play, too. I'll be so tight with your cousin Steve. He'll invite me over for Christmas Eve. I'll dance your mama all around the room, then present the bride and groom.
Last year's Tony-winning featured actress in a musical, Sara Ramirez. Plus, a special moment from the longest-running show in Broadway history and a performance by the cast of the Threepenny Opera when we return on CBS. The 60th Annual Tony Awards, sponsored by Olay, love the skin you're in, and Fosamax Plus D.
I have a memory of presenting one to Robert Morse, who was so, when he won for True.
And the award goes to Robert Morse.
He was just so thrilled to be up there and long hugs, and he took so long before he started speaking.
You're right in here with me, and this is for all of us.
Welcome the chairman of the American Theater Wing, Sandra Gilman, and board president, Douglas Leeds.
60 years ago, the American Theater Wing founded the Antoinette Perry Awards.
Of all the exciting nights that happen each year, the Tony Awards is still the most spectacular of all the nights on Broadway.
Whoa! 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 Of all the nights of Broadway, we are the most spectacular.
Ah! Excuse me?
Didn't you call for these spectacular nights on Broadway?
Ah!
No.
I definitely heard Knights on Broadway.
Yeah, so did I.
Yeah, they're lying. Cut off their heads.
Ow! 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 Ow!
We are the Knights who say from Spamalot!
Spamalot!
No. They're here to talk about the good work they do on Broadway.
Ah, yes. The American Theatre Wing serves both the theatrical community and the public with programs designed to advance the art of live theatre.
Yes, they produce educational seminars on TV and Downstage Centre on XM Satellite Radio, a national program to help audiences better appreciate live theatre.
Yes, and apparently they have a website where you can download hundreds of hours of free audio and video.
And since its inception, our grants program has awarded more than $2.5 million to New York City nonprofit theaters.
We also support theater interns and aspiring artists as they embark on professional careers.
Bravo, Tony Peasants, and thanks for our Tony.
Told you it was a mistake to ask them.
Welcome last year's Tony-winning featured actress for Spamalot, along with an actor most recently seen on Broadway in Noises Off, Sara Ramirez and T.R. Knight.
Ah, good evening, everyone. Just as storytellers pass on their tales, and dancers pass on their what, T.R.?
You have a Tony Award.
Yeah, but,
That's so cool. You know who else, best featured actress in a musical? Tony Award? Gwen Verdon. Cool. Tammy Grimes? Cool. Andrea Martin? She's cool.
Can I continue?
Yes!
Great. And so, just as storytellers pass on their tales, dancers pass on their steps, and actors pass on their techniques to the next group of performers, let's pass on the mantle of Tony winner.
Can I touch the envelope?
No.
No.
The nominees for Best Performance by a Featured Actress are Carolee Carmello, Lestat. Felicia P. Fields, The Color Purple. Megan Lawrence for Pajama Game. Beth Level for The Drowsy Chaperone. and Elizabeth Withers Mendez for The Color Purple.
And the American Theatre Wing's Tony Award goes to...
Yes, Beth Level, The Drowsy Chaperone!
Beth Level wins her first Tony Award, handling the role of the title character in the musical, The Drowsy Chaperone.
My goodness gracious sakes alive. breathe. First of all, thank you, Bob Martin and Janet Vandergraaff, for getting married and having this amazing bachelor party thing that has become our Drowsy Chaperone. Thank you, life, for the privilege of being on the same page as Felicia and Elizabeth and Megan and Carolee. Overwhelmed. Thank you. Thank you to our producers. Thank you, our creative team. And I must tell my director, my brilliant director, Casey Nicolaw. I had to write this down. Thank you for trusting me with this role of a lifetime. Because of your faith in me, my friend, I am flying. Thank you, sister. Thank you, Pat Sullivan, my wrangler. Thank you, Mark Redante and the boys at Bauman, Redante and Shaw. Thank you, John Milne, my husband, I love you. Thank you, TJ and Sam, I love you. And thank you, American Theater Wing. for letting this be Lynn and Ruby Level in Raleigh, North Carolina's. They're the proudest parents on the earth right now. Cheers, darling. I love my job. Thank you.
Please welcome a Tony winner for Barnum and nominee tonight, along with his co-star from the Threepenny Opera, Jim Dale and Anna Gasteyer.
Thank you so very much. Thank you. Set in London, our second nominee for Best Revival of a Musical spins the tale of Macheath, an outlaw known as Mac the Knife.
This deliciously dark reimagination of Bertolt Brecht and Kurt Weill's classic is wrapped in leather for your protection.
So now, Alan Cummings, Cyndi Lauper, and one of the most wonderful casts on Broadway, the Threepenny Opera.
Her soul and mine entwined, we shared all things together happily. I used my mind and I protected her. She used her body and supported me. To be poor is an illness, and this was the cure. So when a customer appeared, I'd leave our bed, I'd go outside and I'd have beers and cheese and bread. And when he paid and he could have a snack, well, I'd say, if you liked it, please come back. And then you'd wash beneath the golden dome of that cold brothel, and
and pull my hair. Then later on, one time he hit me with a stick, and I lay down because I felt quite sick. So life was sweet beneath that golden dome of that cold brothel
where we made our home. And in those days, so weren't as sad and grim as they are now.
It's true, we made love only in the day.
By night, the farmer's girl had to pull the plow. It wasn't normal, but we could still play.
You will agree.
So when we always sit on top of me,
because he didn't want to hurt our little child.
But then it died one night in May and she went wild.
We said goodbye in June beneath the dome
of that cold brothel which we called our
home.
come, Oprah Winfrey and Glenn Close. And up next, Tony winner Christine Ebersole with John Tartaglia and Rod from Avenue Q. Plus, special presentations by Essie Paytha Murkison, Stanley Tucci, and Brian Stokes Mitchell with the Lifetime Achievement Award when the 60th Annual Tony Awards returns on CBS. Please welcome two Tony nominees, Essie Paytha Murkison and Stanley Tucci.
The nominees for Best Play have been authored by four of today's most perceptive playwrights.
It is our pleasure to present this year's engrossing nominated works.
Set in Northern England classroom during the mid-1980s, Alan Bennett's cuttingly funny story of the History Boys concerns a teacher and his unruly boys who seek a place at the university. At stake are the relationships of the teacher, his peers, and his students, and the unsettling secret they all share.
Child, I am your teacher. Whatever I do in this room is a token of my trust. I'm in your hands.
Placed in 1993 on a rocky island in County Galway, Martin McDonagh's Lieutenant of Inishmore is a scorchingly black comedy about political terrorism. A brutal Irish Liberation Army enforcer with an obsessive attachment to his beloved cat goes on a murderous spree of revenge.
So this is Wee Thomas, is this?
It is.
It is.
We think.
Well, hello there, Wee Thomas. It's nice to be seeing you again after all this time.
A suburban New York home is the setting for David Lindsay Abair's Rabbit Hole, which gracefully examines a family's tragedy with humor, pathos, and insight. A young couple's marriage is turned upside down as they try to cope with the accidental death of their child.
At some point, it becomes bearable, turns into something you can crawl out from under and carry around like a brick in your pocket.
Situated in Dublin, Conor McPherson's Shining City tells the story of a man who seeks counseling when he sees the ghost of his recently deceased wife. The unusual encounter becomes a desperate struggle between the living and the dead, which deeply affects both men for the rest of their lives.
I've seen her.
Sorry, you've seen her?
I've seen her in the house. She's been in the house. Yeah.
Those are the thought-provoking nominees for Best Play 2006.
We'll find out which of these inspiring new works will take home the Tony later in tonight's show.
Please welcome the star of Grey Gardens, a Tony winner for 42nd Street, Christine Ebersole, and a Tony nominee for Avenue Q, John Tartaglia and Rod.
Sweet frozen fudgesicles, it's Christine Ebersole from 42nd Street. Oh, I love you, Christine.
Oh, wait. Thank you. I don't believe we've met.
Oh, hi, I'm Rod. I'm a puppet, and I'm also a Republican.
A Republican puppet? That rings a bell.
Christine. You're too much, Christine. You. You charmer, you. Oh, Christine, this is such a thrill for me to be here because, you know, I live for musicals. I mean, the lights, the costumes, Alan Cumming. Call me.
The nominees for Best Performance by a Featured Actor in a Musical are Danny Burstein, the Drowsy Chaperone.
Jim Dale, the Three Penny Opera.
Brandon Victor Dixon, The Color Purple.
Manuel Falciano, Sweeney Todd.
And Christian Hoff, Jersey Boys. And the 2000...
Oh, no, Christine, can I do it, please? It would mean the world to me.
Please, please, it's everything I've ever wanted. Except for Alan Cumming.
I've never been this close to a Republican puppet.
It's exciting for both of us. Okay, here we go. Okay. The 2006 Tony Award goes to Kristen Hopkins.
Wins his first Tony Award for his compelling portrayal of Tommy DeVito in the musical Jersey Boys.
Oh my God. Thank you so much. Thank you. Papa, this is for us. He died when he was 52. He immigrated to this country in 1961, the year Sherry broke, and he met my mom working at Saks Fifth Avenue. And as a proud first-generation American, I celebrate this story every night with my man, Tommy DeVito, who gave me the shoes to fill, and the heart and soul of a king, warts and all. Nobody's perfect. This is a perfect story, though, thanks to Des McAnuff, Marshall Brickman, and Rick Ellis. Yeah. Without which, we wouldn't be able to weave this intricate story in this iconic music that we get to play every night. I thank my wife, Melissa Hoff, for coming to me and saving me and being there as a mother for my children, our new baby in her womb right now. Hi, baby. And Lord, I thank you for bringing me back home to Broadway, and thank you for welcoming me. God bless Broadway. Thank you.
Please welcome a Tony winner for Kiss Me, Kate, Brian Stokes Mitchell.
Thank you, friends. Thank you. Good evening. 1 year after the Tony Awards were established, Hal Prince began his Broadway career as an intern for the legendary director, playwright, and producer George Abbott. He learned from the best and learned fast. Soon, Hal found early success producing The Pajama Game and building a distinguished career marked with the most memorable shows on Broadway. As producer, his many hits include West Side Story, A Funny Thing Happened on the Way to the Forum, Fiddler on the Roof, and Damn Yankees. Cabaret was his first major triumph as producer and director. And as director, he's known for his breathtaking productions of Sweeney Todd, Evita, Kiss of the Spider-Woman, The Phantom of the Opera, and his revolutionary rethinking of Showboat. Tonight, to go with his 20 Tonys, we are delighted to present the Lifetime Achievement Tony Award to Hal Prince, who is currently in Las Vegas mounting a new production of Phantom.
Thank you for this honor, and thank you for letting me work most of my adult life on Broadway. I've had my successes, which have flopped at the box office, my humiliating misfires, and some shows that have run, for which I'm extremely grateful. I've also had decades of working with the most brilliant creative artists in the American theater. I'm a lucky guy.
Now, in honor of Hal Prince, from his production, which this year became the longest running show in Broadway history, please welcome Howard McGillan, the Phantom of the Opera.
floating, falling, sweet intoxication. Touch me. Let your darker side give in to the power of the music that I write. Help me make the music of the night.
Coming up, Julia Roberts presents the award to the leading actor. Will it be Ralph Fiennes, Richard Griffiths, Jelko Ivanek, Oliver Platt, or David Wilmot? Find out next when the 60th Annual Tony Awards returns on CBS.